Before proceeding, please make sure to subscribe Dinshal Maniac and turn on the bell icon to get notified on each upcoming video. You can always support my work with your likes, comments, and shares, and you can join me on Facebook and Instagram through the links given at the description box. Almost every one of us experiences some sort of tooth problems throughout our lives. Have you ever wondered why? Dental caries, commonly called tooth decay or cavities, is one of the most common dental diseases and is experienced by all age types. Let's see why and how. Our oral cavity, which comprises the soft tissues and teeth, are full of numerous types of microbes. These microbes use the leftover food on our teeth as a substrate for their energy production and produces acids as a byproduct. These acids, when left for a long period, attack the outer surface of our teeth, called the enamel, and starts the demineralization or the decalcification process. Hence, a cavity or a hole is produced. The amount of acids produced is based on what we eat and how much sugar we consume. In certain foods like carbonated drinks, candies, and biscuits, sugars are present in their free form. However, in certain foods like vegetables, nuts, and different grains, sugars are present in the form of carbohydrates. The carbohydrates present in these foods are broken down into sugars with the help of certain enzymes present in our oral cavity and eventually are used as a source of energy for the living bacteria. Besides the destructive processes produced by the acid-forming bacteria, which uses sugar as a substrate on our teeth, nature has also given us some protective factors in our oral cavity in the form of saliva. Saliva, as it has a high amount of calcium and phosphate, remineralizes the demineralized tooth and can reverse caries in its initial stages. It also helps prevent tooth decay by washing away sticky and sugary foods from the tooth surface, and it dilutes the acids produced by the bacteria. Although we have got the protective factors in the form of saliva, the exact problem starts from the constant burden of acids produced by frequent consumption of sugary foods, which overburdens the saliva to heal the tooth and results in a more mineral loss from the tooth surface, causing the demineralization process beyond repair. This damage, which is beyond repair, results in a weakened and broken down enamel over time, hence the tooth forms a hole or a cavity. The destruction follows a series of stages, and to understand these series of stages, we must first understand the layers of a tooth. Let's take a cross-section of this tooth to look at its layers. The main three layers of the tooth are the outer enamel layer, or the white of a tooth, the underlying dentine, and the core of a tooth, or the dental pulp, which comprises the nerves and blood vessels of a tooth. The destruction of a tooth through a caries process follows a series of five stages. The initial stage of a caries lesion is characterized by a chalky white spot on enamel. This white spot is the demineralized zone of a tooth surface formed by the continuous acid attack. In the second stage, the white spot lesion turns into a black spot, which is limited to the outer enamel layer of a tooth only. This outer surface of enamel is known as the hardest tissue of the human body, and it's quite resistant to decay. At this stage, the patient might not feel any discomfort or pain. In the third stage, the enamel of the tooth is breached by the caries process, and the destruction proceeds deeper to the second layer or to the dentine of the tooth. The caries process now spreads more rapidly, and the patient usually feels discomfort and pain with the stimulus, such as pain with hot or cold foods. The stage of the extreme and unbearable pain is when the infection from the caries lesion reaches its fourth stage and involves the tooth pulp. The tooth pulp is the core of the tooth and is filled with blood vessels and nerves. This is the time when the patient experiences extreme and spontaneous pain with or without a stimulus, and especially at nights. If the patient does not consult the dentist even at this extreme pain stage, the infection of the dental pulp or the pulpitis can then progress to the bone and causes a dental abscess. That's why it's always wiser to consult a dentist when a caries lesion is at its initial stage. How can we treat a tooth decay? The treatment of tooth decay differs in each stage. In the initial stage of a white spot lesion, no treatment is required and the caries process can be reversed with the help of proper oral hygiene. In the second stage, when only the enamel is involved, patient only needs the removal of the affected area with the dental drill and the cavity be filled with the final restorative material. In its third stage, when decay has breached enamel and progressed the second layer of the dentine but has not reached the pulp yet, the patient might still need the removal of the affected area filled with the restoration only. And in the fourth and fifth stages, when the caries process has reached the pulp or beyond it to the bone, the patient experiences extreme and spontaneous pain, patient will most probably need a root canal treatment, where the nerves and blood vessels of a tooth are completely removed with the help of endodontic files, and then the cavity is filled. Sometimes the tooth may be extracted and then replaced with a crown, bridge, or a dental implant. So, it's always much simpler and much affordable to prevent tooth decay rather than to repair or replace a decayed tooth. It's recommended to do regular dental checkup so that caries can be treated in its very initial stages as compared to the more extensive and painful treatments in its later and advanced stages. How can we prevent a tooth decay? Dental caries or tooth decay can be prevented with a three-step measure. Step number one. Focus on your diet. Don't take too much sugary foods and carbonated drinks. The less sugary foods you take, the less acid is produced by the bacteria present in our oral cavity and our teeth will be less prone to caries. Step number two, do home care oral hygiene methods like brushing twice daily for 2 minutes regularly and flossing every night before bed. And finally, step number three, having routine professional dental examinations and dental hygiene performed by a dentist at a dental clinic. I hope this video helps. If you think this video was really helpful, please do like the video and share it with friends. Please do subscribe the channel and turn on the bell icon to get notified on each upcoming video. In case if you have any doubts about dental decay, you may write down your questions in the comment section below. Thank you for watching.